When it's time to start, talk about the hair stands up in my arms, then it's time to focus. Before that, you joke around and you try to keep it light because you don't want to get too intense.
For 3.5 seconds, 4 seconds, I'm all by myself in that car. It's the most quietest time you'll ever want to hear. I mean, nobody's yelling at me, nobody's screaming. And this is beautiful, man. I mean, I wish I could do that every day for hours.
For these two drivers, their drag race car is their favorite place to be. But for their fans and family, it's a whole new level of excitement. Drills fixing cars and engines blasting all around you, causing you to jump out of the stands with tears running down your face from the nitro. Unfortunately, not everyone can make it out to the drag race to experience it. So goods and tools and supplies brought the atmosphere to Winona.
When you bring the general public in who's never experienced the sensory overload of what a top fuel car can do. But when I leave the starting line, I have no fat and I have no wrinkles because it's on the starting line. This car in the first 60 feet will go about 104 to 106 miles an hour.
With 40 years under his belt in the racing community, McMillan is hungry for a title and is so close with being ranked number 8 in the nation. Dale Creasy Jr. is just as hungry for a title, and he is counting on his family and friends to push him toward one.
My mom's there every race, my nephew comes with me, and all my crew guys have been with us for the longest, over 30 years, some 20 and 15 years. Had the same guys, all guys we went to school with and friends that we've had forever. So it's a family atmosphere.
McMillan is also grateful for his family and his crew's family for traveling over 80,000 miles with him to all 24 races for support. From HBC Sports, I'm Alyssa Kozak.